It was never my M.O., if you've ever read anything about me before, to ever say anything bad about anyone that I'd ever gone with. And it just that this thing was so crazy. And like I say, I pushed my fool button, and there I was, a fool.
Yeah.
And then you just can't live it down. I mean, there's contests on every, I mean, vote for Burt, vote for her, vote for, I mean, it's just, it's unbelievable that it's just still going on.
Yeah. Are you a hard guy to live with normally, would you say? I mean.
Well, you never had a problem.
No, I know. We all got I can honestly say I never did.
No, I think I'm very easy to, yeah, to get, live with. But,
would you get married again? Or have you kind of soured on the deal for a while? I don't mean
just
like
for
right
a
now.
While.
For
I
a
think.
While. Yeah.
I think I understand that Texas is a good place to get married.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. No, I don't know. I think that if you get soured on marriage because of your situation, then you're a little bit crazy. You know, that situation was that situation, and then there'll be others. I hope.
When you get angry, and you're by yourself, and you get angry, do you rearrange furniture?
Yes.
I mean, I sort of heard of things flying through the air. I mean, you know.
No, I rearrange chairs.
Oh, okay. This is.
No, I have been known to break furniture.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Just throw it across.
But it's always mine.
Oh yeah, yeah.
I want that very clear.
I'll break your hat.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh. Never touched anybody else's furniture.
But is it good once you do that? Once you break the furniture, you say to yourself, "That's it. I'm clear."
Sometimes I need another chair.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right now, I'd like to have a chair.
I think you probably. Why do I think you just went through a whole dinette set about?
I did.
A week ago.
I did. I went through. Yeah. I went through the whole house actually. But I just walked out of the house with my Rotary Club football trophy. That was it.
Yeah.
Yeah. And so I.
How about?
I didn't take a lot.
How about your dad? Did he? Did he give you much advice? I know your dad is.
My dad is a ex chief police, and he's 90 years old, and he gave me some. He gave me some very sage advice, which I can't say on the air.
Yeah. Yeah. You can't even hint about what it is on the air.
No, I can't. I can't say anything about that because it was terrific, but I can't say it.
Yeah. Yeah.
It was kind of like what Sinbad said to me, yeah, just back in the dressing room. You know that Sinbad just got a divorce, too.
I'm sure he'd be thrilled that you said that.
Yeah, well, I mean.
The first rule of show business, take somebody
down
with you.
I think it's time.
Let me ask you an honest question. Are you nervous tonight? Do you seem nervous coming on? Because I must admit, every time I've seen you, it's bang, bang, and the lines and the jokes. And tonight you do seem...
to be setting you up.
No, but you do seem... you seem a little nervous, as if you think maybe you've lost the public or you've lost the appeal they have for you. No, that's...
Well, there is that feeling that you've disappointed people because you didn't stay, you know. I mean, we were the top of the wedding cake, you know.
Yeah.
But so was Desi and Lucy.
Yeah, yeah.
And the royal family.
Yeah.
So, I mean, people, I don't think there's anybody in this audience that hasn't been affected by a divorce in one way or another. And when people get so angry about it that you feel a responsibility to stay married. Just for a minute.
No, I know. How about your son? How's Quentin? Is he taking you?
Quentin is the most well-adjusted, wonderful young man I've ever met. And he thinks he has two houses now. He's really happy. Hey, I got two houses.
Yeah.
Got two houses, two pools.
Yeah.
One's a little small. A waiting pool at my house. Yeah, but, and he likes to come down to the valley where it's hot, where I am.
Oh, yeah, right.
Yeah. I've moved so many times, folks, that it's frightening. You can just check my whole career by where I've moved.
You should get a Winnebago.
I have. In fact, I was living in one for about a week or two.
Yeah.
There.
You did a movie as well?
I directed and was in a movie with Reba McEntire, and she's one. Called A Man from Left Field, about baseball.
Oh, it's a baseball movie, okay.
Yeah. Yes. The man from left field would make you think that.
I would think that, a man from left field.
But you're such a big sports fan.
It could be my biography, The Man from Left Field.
You don't know anything about sports. It's frightening.
Me?
No, you don't care about sport. Let's go back and the Raiders.
I was at the Rams game yesterday, beat the Steelers 27 to nothing.
I saw you. I saw you at that game, and who explained it to you?
Who explained it? I was there.
No, I know what a big sports. I know
were
what
you
a big,
at the game? Were you
the Rams
at,
game?
Were you at the Rams game?
No.
I rest my case. Thank
yes.
you, ladies and gentlemen.
No, I wasn't.
Let's go back to Sinbad's
divorce. I was at the Raiders game.
Oh, you're at the Raiders game?
Yes.
Well, they won also?
Yes.
So there you are.
Yes. I went all the way to Seattle.
He's losing it, ladies and gentlemen. But anyway, we have to go? All right, we'll take it. Listen, congratulations. Thanks for coming
congratulations
on
what?
Congratulations on going to the Raiders game. On the Raiders game. I started saying I'm so used to saying congratulations. Congratulations for being a good sport. That's
Thank
what
you.
It is. For coming out. See how easy this was? See how easy this was? There you go. Burt Reynolds, you guys.
These aren't merely chairs. They're blueprints used by us to help design and create the perfect environment for the driver of the Lexus GS. Because a true performance sedan shouldn't just handle the road, it must also handle its passengers. The Lexus GS.
I'm in this Italian offer to prove how Italian Subway's Italian subs are. A spicy pizza sub and Italian steak, both with Carm's marinara, from a recipe by our founder's mother. So say ciao.
New hot Italian subs from $1.69 at Subway.
Man, when I get a cold, it's a killer cold. Sure, I take Contact. The four-hour medication, like Actifed, it wears off too quick. Get to work in the morning, it's gone. Take Contact in the morning, it works for me.
Contact helps turn sick days into work days.
It's good stuff.
Tomorrow at 5 on the Channel 4 News, the Raiders road to the Super Bowl. Go behind the scenes, catch all the action as the Raiders get ready for the battle in Buffalo. Brett Rogan, Brett Lewis, and the entire Channel 4 News team. Coverage you can count on at 5.
The year's most sensual love story has now won 6 Golden Globe nominations, including Best Picture, Best Director, Best Actress, Best Screenplay. The Piano, rated R, now playing at select theaters. Starts Saturday at a theater near you.
Tonight, Conan tries to run a classy show with Geraldine Ferraro, Peter Horton, and boxer Vinny Pazienza, but Andy has other ideas. Tonight.
Last week, over 33 million viewers witnessed Homicide. The Daily News calls it sizzling, superb drama. You've got to watch Homicide. After Seinfeld, NBC Thursday.
Hi, I'm Lisa Gibbons, reminding you to make a date to join me next week here on NBC Daytime for my new talk show, Lisa. We'll talk about things like what women really want from men and how to get it, both in and out of the bedroom. And the anatomy of an affair, how to tell and what to do if it's happening to you. You'd be surprised, men aren't the only ones cheating. And when we said for better or worse, that means sticking with a husband who had a sex change operation? All that and more in the premiere week of Lisa, starting Monday.
Announcing C&R's clearance sale. We're exploding with savings. The lowest prices of the year. Our entire fall inventory on sale. Save up to 50%. Hurry.
The critics are applauding 6 degrees of separation. Channing's magic.
Extraordinary.
So bright and so comic. Stalker Channing's performance is Oscar caliber brilliant. 6 degrees of separation. Rated R. Now playing at select theaters.
What do you do when Four Wheeler Magazine crowns you Pickup Truck of the Year? You leap up in the air. You take a bow. And you give the runners-up a big wet one on the cheek. Chevy S-Series, Four Wheeler Pickup Truck of the Year. Further proof that everything else is history.
The hottest from Hollywood. Entertainment Tonight, weeknights at 7.
John and Daryl's Romantic Hideaway on hard copy.
We interrupt this program for this Channel 4 News special report.
Hello, everyone. We have an update right now on the earthquake that hit our area in the past hour. This one hit at exactly 11:27 this evening. Radio reports indicate it was centered 2 miles south of Santa Monica. We've had a lot of phone calls in the Channel 4 newsroom this evening. People say it felt like a sudden jolt in their area, a lot of rattled nerves, but we're happy to say there was no damage and no reports of anyone being hurt so far.
We've been checking with the folks out at Caltech, and they officially report now that that was a 3.5 earthquake, a 3.5 magnitude, as Colleen said, 2 miles south of Santa Monica. You'll recall that we had a swarm of earthquakes over the weekend, specifically on Sunday. The highest earthquake on Sunday was a 3.7, and then earlier tonight, at about 10 minutes past 9 o'clock, we also had an earthquake in the same area, and that measured 2.2 on the Richter scale.
Now
no damage.
Say this one was centered in the Santa Monica area, but actually we've had phone calls from Playa del Rey all the way to West L.A. into the San Fernando Valley specifically, Encino, Van Nuys, the Sherman Oaks area. Everyone reporting the same thing. They say it felt like a sudden jolt, although no one reports losing any dishes or pictures or anything like that off the walls.
And once again, Caltech says this is definitely an aftershock from Sunday's earthquakes.
Measuring 3.5. We will have the very latest on all the earthquakes hitting our area and the swarm since Sunday we've felt. Tomorrow morning on Today in L.A., that begins at 5:30.
This has been a Channel 4 News special report. Now back to regular programming.
Yeah, the 12-pack, man.
Not the 3-pack, the 12. Because I remember when you came in, when I first met you at Zanies, you were in the Air Force.
I was just getting out the Air Force. I just got kicked out. Don't be proud.
It was the most polite.
It was a beautiful thing. It was
the most polite he'd ever been to me. You came up, Mr. Leno, I want to be a comedian. Remember I let you? I said,
that's right.
Oh, you want to be a comedian?
Go on. This man was like one of those guys that, you know, all the comics, when Jay would come to town, everybody wanted to sit down, and he'd take you to eat. He'd go to a cheap place because he wouldn't spend much money. And all the comics would sit around Jay Leno. How would I get into comedy?
Do your thing.
He never gave advice that made you money. It was stupid stuff when you thought about it later on.
I remember the first joke you told that night.
You remember it?
It was about Poor Folks Restaurant. You know Poor Folks?
Poor Folks.
Remember the joke?
The Poor Folks Restaurant. See, Poor Folks is only in the South. Mm-hmm. And it's called P-O-F-O-L-K-S.
I used to own a few of them.
You have some? And now we might have to get another one.
Yeah,
we have to get another one.
And I'll be washing dishes there.
I'll be eating there.
The ample title for me now.
And what they do is they write the menu like you pull, because you pull, it must mean you're stupid. Because they would write down sandwiches. What kind of sandwiches? And after a while, about after 15 minutes of poor folks, you act like that. Can I have a sandwich? And everybody would get stupid inside the restaurant.
No, exactly. Just because I'm poor don't mean I'm illiterate.
That's right.
Was the actual line.
And also want people to know, on the Jay Leno show, they give you a key to lock your stuff up because there's a lot of thievery, I guess, going on. I don't understand this. I've done other shows that didn't steal my stuff.
No, no. Let me tell you something.
They give you one?
They gave me one, yeah.
They gave you one?
I don't think you got to worry about anybody taking this jacket. I think you'll be all right.
Oh, okay.
Now, how's your little boy? He must be starting school.
Yeah, today was his first day of school. He's 4 years old. It's K-4. Wow. Well, you know, he went to daycare and last year, but, you know, because nowadays you got to get kids in school at the age of 2.
True.
Because you got to take a test to go into kindergarten. How can you not be ready for kindergarten? How can you be so mentally undeveloped, like,
I don't think we should send him yet. They're building blocks. They're sleeping. He's not ready for that challenge.
I'm like, that is the dumbest thing. And my son, you know, he was cool. He had a book bag and he had new clothes. And he was like, Daddy, we're going to school. And we got to the door. No! And took off down the street. And then the other kids got agitated. And they says, he knows something we don't know. And they ran out the door.
Talk more with Sinbad. Be right back right after this.
MCI called, and they want friends and family phone numbers, and if they are on that friends and family, you get a better deal. Well, nobody was in my family, so it's not a better deal.
I thought we were going to save a lot of money, and we didn't.
You want to give us savings? Give us savings. Just give it to us.
You got it. Introducing AT&T True USA Savings. Spend over $25 a month and get a 20% discount off your AT&T calls anywhere in the USA.
They said, oh, give us your friends' names and their phone numbers.
You have to count on other people for you to get the discount.
The reason they want the numbers is so they can call these people.
And so what's the MCI?
Some of my friends got upset.
We don't make you sign up anyone but you. If you're a Friends and Family Basic or Primetime customer, you could save more with True USA Savings.
They bothered me too much, and I'm going to switch back to AT&T.
With True USA Savings, you can get 20% off your AT&T long-distance calls anytime to anyone, guaranteed.
Bye, MCI.
Your true voice.
Citibank has really given us a new sense of self because we have our own identity.
I have a Citibank Visa card, and it does have my photo on it, so I have one less worry.
And not only that, but you can pick what you like. So it doesn't look like a DMV photo.
I don't know why the other credit cards aren't doing the same thing.
We need a photo card so family members can tell us apart.
Introducing the first credit card with your photo and signature on front from not just Visa, Citibank Visa.
You know your NyQuil works.
What'd you do?
You tried the latest thing, so you coughed all night.
Got no rest. Ended up a zombie. And your proposal to the world's most demanding boss? Postponed until tomorrow.
Which means you can take NyQuil tonight.
You're stupid, Dave, but lucky.
Vicks NyQuil, the nighttime sniffling, sneezing, coughing, aching, stuffy head fever so you can rest medicine. Also new NyQuil hot therapy.
We've been talking it over. Your future, that is.
Am I being fired?
Tom Hanks.
What happened to your face?
I have AIDS.
Denzel Washington.
You want to sue Wyatt Wheeler?
I have a case.
And a story of fear.
You didn't know he was sick.
Did you, Bob?
Prejudice.
What deviant groups did he belong to?
And courage.
Who makes these rules? You?
Philadelphia, a Jonathan Demme picture. Rated PG-13.
Now playing select theaters Friday everywhere.
Sinbad. Now, I remember you on the road. You would watch TV till like 6 in the morning.
That's right, man.
Had those comedy condos.
I had no life. Back in those days, we would stay in comedy condos. Like, it was condos. It might be an apartment. It might be the owner's house.
Or a garage.
Yeah. Or it might be outside just in the yard.
Yeah.
And we called them condos. And there was never any cable.
No.
You had like 4 channels, and there was nothing else to do. It was comics. So you get off at midnight. Everybody else was gone, so you just stay up and watch TV all night.
Yeah.
And talk about stuff the next day that nobody knew about because everybody else had lives.
Yeah.
And they had no idea what you were talking about.
But you used to like all the bad movies. That was
really... I go to bad movies on purpose.
Yeah.
Anything that Siskel Ebert don't like, I'm going.
Oh, yeah? Yeah.
I'm checking it out.
Yeah.
I'm checking it out.
What bad movies have you seen?
I've seen a lot of my pictures. The thing about Burt Reynolds, everybody wanted to be Burt Reynolds. Every boy, black, white, Japanese, I don't care what you were, wanted to be Burt Reynolds, man. I wanted to be the longest yard. Oh. That was me, man. I wanted to wear the tight black silk t-shirt with sideburns. You go like this. Can I talk to you for a second? That's all I wanted to do, man. That's what I wanted to do.
Well, I bought you. You see, my Citroen SM is the same car you drove in the longest shot. Remember that you drove into the water?
I don't care.
You don't. You probably don't have that car anymore. Anyway, congratulations. Listen, I mean. Do you ever buy anything with a home shopping? Are you one of those guys you watch?
I can't help it. I try not to watch.
See,
man.
I can only go about 3 minutes.
I bought the ball spray so I can spray the back of my head.
Oh, yeah.
They might run out, and I want to have some.
Yeah, they might run out?
Yeah, because I don't think that stuff's going to be around long.
No.
I saw some at Builders Emporium. They had it in the little paint section so you could, like, paint your house or paint your head. They don't care. And that one guy is just too happy. I don't know the guy. He must make all the money. Wow! What can we do with this cup? We can dry it, we can eat it, we can fry it. How much? Not 39, not 29, $5. I ain't buying nothing for $5.
No, you gotta buy that.
You know it's jacked up, it's only $5, man.
So you're the guy. You know, I always wonder who buys this stuff.
I buy it, but I send it back.
Oh, can you do that? I didn't even know.
Oh, they know. Ooh.
Can you send it back?
You can send it back. Break it and send it back. Say it was broke when you got it.
I do. You ever do the psychic thing? You ever call?
I call the psychic hotline all the time, man, because I believe there are people out there who have abilities, but not that many that you can get an 800 number. I'm sorry. I believe there are like one or two dudes that really can go like, Jay, you shouldn't go to work today. Now, I don't think, you know, once, I mean, these guys come on, you know, and you never get the one that's on the show. The one that's good. He says shit like this. I've worked with entertainers. And you call, hi, this is Sally from Iowa.
Right.
I'm going, oh, like, you know what's happening. You'd move if you knew what was happening. You go to a city that has some, like, amusement park or something. I call and say, what exactly am I going to be doing tomorrow? Well, I can't tell you exactly what I'm hanging up.
Right.
I mean, and then it costs you $29.95 just to call the people. Plus, who else is up at midnight to read your mind? That's stupid. Who stays up all that long? I hope they call. I've got a lot of feelings in my head today. I just...
Big sports fan? You watch sports all day like that?
Yeah, I'm a sports fan, but I'm not religious like I used to be. I used to be a basketball nut and everything, but now I try to have a life.
Yeah.
You know, because there's so much sports on now. You got a satellite dish. You're like this. Oh, what? Oh, what the? They got contracts. I don't.
Yeah, right.
Play the game. Put it in the paper. I'll read what you did, man.
Now, the new show is called Sinbad. What are the odds of that, really?
Well, I called it the Sinbad Show because, you know, I want people to say, like, I know you're on the air. It's called the Sinbad Show. That way, when they're looking for it in TV Guide, they'll have to go like, oh, it's me and the kids, or Jim and Jam. It's
right.
Like the Sinbad Show.
So what is it now? You're a dad or something?
I'm a guy who was a single man. He'd been single all his life, never planned on being married. And, it's a dream life, man. He was single, and all of a sudden he decides to adopt two kids, and it totally changes his life up.
Oh, he adopts two children. How old, little kids, teenagers?
Four. I got one. My daughter's four, and the son of the show is 12. Okay. Anybody that has kids knows what happens. Once you have kids, you'll never be cool again. You become brain damaged, and you just lie about how cool you used to be.
Yeah.
Right? Right? See, these are parents.
Now, when is the show on? It's on Thursday?
On Thursday, right after the Simpsons. It's on Thursday.
On Fox.
On Fox.
We can say it.
It's on Fox. And on Fox.
No, I think...
You don't get one of these, Jack.
Yeah, that's right. There you go. That's right. You don't get the key.
The Standard, an automobile seat that may transfer bumps from the road and aggravate your back. The Higher Standard in the all-new Cadillac DeVille is new suspension seating, which acts like a shock absorber for the driver's back, isolating you from bumps to help reduce back pressure and increase circulation, which should leave you more refreshed mile after mile. Suspension seating in the new V8-powered DeVille by Cadillac. Creating a higher standard.
Family's eating dinner together.
I don't have time for togetherness.
15 minutes?
Be a 15-minute cook with Kraft macaroni and cheese. One cup meat and one cup vegetables. To the cheesiest, add tuna and peas. Make a complete dinner recipe in only 15 minutes.
Good dinner, Mom.
That's dinner, Mom. Gotta go.
Gotta go.
Gotta go.
Kraft macaroni and cheese recipes. If you've got 15 minutes, you've got dinner.
This Goodyear Aqua Tread pumps away over a gallon of water every second with its deep groove aqua channel. That's 396 gallons per mile. Think about it. The all-season Aqua Tread, only from Goodyear.
If you hate the taste of cough syrup, throw in the spoon. Introducing Rixall Cough Liquid Caps. Each one's concentrated to give you 8 hours of relief with no bad taste. New Rixall Cough Liquid Caps. Isn't that better?
Wednesday, arresting television with all new Unsolved Mysteries. A charming older boy, a trusting young girl, until his attraction became an obsession. Find this fugitive. Then on Now, should you be allowed to decide your own death?
It's a right that you should have the choice.
An exclusive with Dr. Kevorkian. And on Law & Order, he claims he was kidnapped, but was he really trying to steal his parents' money?
He nearly took your father for $5 million.
An all-new Law & Order, after Unsolved Mysteries and Now, arresting television, NBC Wednesday.
So
Association has nominated my next guest for 8 awards, including Album of the Year for his latest CD, I Still Believe in You. He'll be performing here in Los Angeles at the Universal Amphitheater this Friday, September 17th. Joined now by the Tonight Show band, Vince Gill.
When you're all alone, no, there's nothing like a woman to make a man come home. She's always there to understand, little boy. Nothing at all. She knows when to hold you, when to leave you alone. She's there to console you with everything. Light a candle, gets a look in her eyes. She says, boy, can you handle staying up with me all night? Oh, there's nothing like a woman when you're all. Thank you.
happily married guys sit on this side.
Okay. Congratulations.
How long have you been married? Congratulations. How long have you been married?
13 years.
13. I've been married 13 also. There you are. Thank you very much. And congratulations. Now, you guys work together, right? You work with
Burt. I've never met the man.
You never met the man. Why show business just like that?
Actually, I did Evening Shade with Reba. We had a duet out called The Heart Won't Lie a while back. And yeah. We went and sang that song on his show.
Now, I got to ask you something, because I was talking to some people about you, and they told me you once opened for Kiss.
That's correct.
Now this I don't understand.
Well, it's not so much that somebody that I opened for him, but I opened for him in a bluegrass band, which is really bizarre.
Who's the promoter?
It was an accident. It happened about 6 o'clock the night of the show, and I said, can you come down and play? We said, yeah. So we grabbed fiddles and banjos and ran down there. And you gotta see this, and it's like a scene from, what was the movie, Spinal Tap. We've got this little bass amp. It's about this big. And they've got their whole wall of stuff. It was pretty hysterical. We got booed off the stage. It went over about as good as the ice cream joke.
Oh, there you go. Oh, really? Oh, man. Well, listen, congratulations on your 8 nominations. Not in 20 years that's happened, right?
Yeah, since Merle Haggard.
All right, since Merle Haggard. Vince Gill, right back, right after.
Some people are pretty sure they're going to buy a Toyota Corolla DX until they find out the Honda Civic LX sedan gets you power windows, power door locks, power mirrors, cruise control, a tachometer, and a 4-speaker stereo cassette, all standard, and the Civic saves you $1,700 over a comparably equipped Corolla. Then they tend to reverse their position. Opt for the Civic. From Honda. In a